So when a fabric has a pattern that's going in one direction, then you have to sort of be a little bit extra cautious and cut in so that the panel, the pattern folds one way. Now normally we just cut, generally we just cut folded, but that way the pattern folds out on the wrong side. Now I'm going to be cutting the panels out of this, and I wasn't quite sure which piece is going to come out towards the bottom, but I'm going to have to mess around and see what I can do. Now the panels, this is the center panel that I've laid on here, and I'm going to be doing the side panels out of this. Now the side panel is going to have like a drooped effect to the one side, and then I want obviously the waisted area and the armhole. And here what we want is this area, we want it sort of angled out so that it's more flared out from the bottom and more fitted around the waist area. So this when it's reattached will look like this. Maybe perhaps a little bit more towards the, now I may have to join pieces towards the shoulder point depending on where the next pieces are going to fall onto. So for the moment we've marked it out for the armhole. Now this obviously comes with experience, right? And if you're sewing for yourself, you become a judge of where the points are to what. But you have to be bold and grab the bull by the horn and just go for it, really, which is exactly what I do with a lot of my sewing. Now, that piece will take away, and already you can see the shape of the dress. Now if we need to widen this a little bit, which sometimes we are actually going on the outer side of the marked line. Okay, so that is now the two panels for the front. Now we need to do the same panels for the back. So first of all, get your fabric and lay it out. We are going to have a major problem with this because we're not going to be able to get the pieces out from that are going to match equally. Sugar. That means that I have to go like this in order to get sugar. Okay, so there's a major problem that the only way that these pieces actually are going to combine, and this was a haste cutting, and I've gone and made a mistake. So what we're gonna have now on the back is the fact that well, on the front, we're going to have the panels are going to go in, the pattern is going to go in the one direction, and then on the back, we're going to have the pattern that's going to go in the other direction. The other problem that we have is that this, the pieces are not coming long enough, so I am going to have to add a piece to this. Because the one thing that I want is when the suit, when the fabric, when these pieces are joined up, I wanted the shades to actually match with each other. But in order to get those shades to match up, if I turn it the other way, these patterns are going the opposite way. So if the red matches, then the yellow will come there. So that's sort of like presented me with a problem, which I wasn't actually prepared for. Never mind, where there's a will, there's always a way. What we're gonna do is we are going to cut into this and we're gonna add some pieces. What else can you do? So we're gonna go ahead and make the best of what we've got. A mistake is only a mistake when you actually tell someone that it's a mistake. If you don't tell someone it's a mistake, it's a design. So here, what we're gonna do is we're gonna carry this off to a finished result, and we're gonna make it like it was meant to be like this. And who's gonna know? And who's gonna be any wiser, eh? Nobody's gonna be any wiser. So what we have is we have the two pieces that are shorter than the other pieces. So we need to lay down our back panel just to get an idea of how short we are. To the bottom of this now, we need to add this much of a piece to the bottom of this to make it same length, and we need to make sure that we add the piece, because this piece will go on the other side of this like that, because that will be the front of the dress. And if we meet these points up, that's the piece that we require. The piece that's going to be the insert in that. Now the colours of that piece are going to be this reddy shade. And we want to get the shading right. So what we're going to do is chop this and chop this to make sure that we're getting Now to get a sleeve that's going to look symmetric, I can only take it out of here, which means that I have to add pieces. Now I don't want to add pieces to the sleeve, so what we're going to do is, the sleeve isn't going to be symmetric, but it doesn't really matter even if we get a red and a green sleeve or a yellow sleeve. This is a very essential point to bear in mind when you buy fabrics, because you could go around trying to match the color to color till you go black in the face, blue in the face, but it's impossible because of the fact that it's extremely, extremely difficult to get. So we are going to get the sleeves, which is going to be, one sleeve is going to have more of the yellow above and red at the bottom, and the other one is going to have, so it's a little bit of a vice versa.